Hello, dear animals. I hope this video finds you well. Today we are going to hang out with Octopus.
Yay!
So go ahead and lower your eyes and come into your body and your breath. Take a couple nice big inhales and exhales. We're gonna start just by picturing that we're in the same room together, that I'm sitting right in front of you and our hearts are connecting. So I'm sending a stream, a river towards your heart of emerald green light. Radiant and bright and coming towards the front of your heart. So just breathe into that energy and you're welcome to practice sending some of that light back towards my heart. Feeling that flow of receiving energy and sending energy. And where do you pull that energy from? Is it the earth? Is it the heavens? Feel where that energy comes from as you pull it and send it out towards me. So just giving you a taste of what that exchange feels like in the kind of human level in our human bodies. This journey with Octopus, we're actually gonna feel what it feels like to be in an octopus body. And so find yourself at the ocean. Maybe it's someplace familiar to you, maybe it's someplace new. And just let yourself sink down into the water. Finding your way to a formation of stones and bigger boulders that are resting in the water at the bottom. And as you swim up towards these rocks, you are aware that you're being watched. You can feel the presence of something that sees you, and you're looking and you can't really see what it is. And then movement catches your eye, and so you focus in on that spot, and you can start to make out the form of an octopus camouflaged against the boulder. And you're just in awe of that ability to hide in nature in that way. Very remarkable skill the octopus has. And now the invitation is for you to actually come into this form of this one before you you've been able to see. And so just feel your body coming closer, and as you approach the octopus, it moves towards you as well until you are suddenly both in the same place. And you can feel the octopus body merging with yours, and you feel that you have in this moment, the eight arms, the different way of feeling the water and moving, and even this fantastic ability to camouflage yourself in the various textures and colors the ocean has. And you feel your heart connected with the heart of this octopus, because it is essentially one and the same in this moment. And so feeling all this, you sort of rush back to the stones, and you feel some of your arms grab tight to hold on to something. And there's a moment in your life right now where these stones actually represent something that you're holding on to in a way, and there's something that your heart knows that's out in the vast ocean that maybe feels a little distant or even impossible, but something that, some dream that's come in to you as a vision of what you would like, what you want to be doing, where you want to be living, what sorts of relationships you want to have, who you want to be, what you want to be contributing to others, your service. There's something in this moment that's, you can feel it out in the ocean. It may even be within sight. You can see it from here. You may know that it's miles away to swim to it. And so in this moment, feel the thing that's you're holding on to, what is the stone in your life right now that as long as you stay connected to it, you won't be moving toward what your heart truly desires? And how many of your arms are grasping tightly to this thing? Is it seven? And one arm sort of feels the freedom of moving forward? Is it four? Maybe you're kind of split 50-50, or maybe it's just one thread, one arm hanging on to this place, this stone in the ocean. And it's scary to let go. It's like really scary because, I mean, there's a reason that you've been where you are. There's a risk to letting go and just being freely floating in the ocean, which is so vast and so many variables. And what if you get lost along the way or something eats you? There's just, you know, a million things that could happen if you let go of this stone. And so of course you've been holding on. It's okay. It's part of it. And so in this moment, you have a choice to just be seeing the risk that it is to let go and swim towards what your heart wants. And at the same time, see the risk of holding on and staying where you are and not moving towards this thing that you desire. And just honor what those things are, that either side has something that you can acknowledge you may hold a little fear around, and love that fear and honor it and be with it and see what feels right to you in this moment. How many of your octopus arms are ready to really let go of this rock in the ocean. And if it's all of them, then you may feel this moment of almost, you know, jumping off a cliff, like, whoa, what do I hold on to now? I just let go and I'm floating in the water. And there's a little bit of excitement and freedom there too, perhaps. And if that doesn't feel safe for you right now, that's okay. It's just acknowledging it. But if you are finding yourself floating completely untethered, then see what it feels like to start to swim. And what's there for you in the water? What things do you start to see as you swim along? The beauty that's there, the possibility, the stones and coral along the way that you can stop and rest at, perhaps. What are the stepping points? And so feel free to stay in this journey for a bit longer if you'd like to explore more. If you're ready to come back, you can come back into your human body. Think the octopus. Deep bow to this one and to you. And thank you so much. If this was of value to you, please, please share it with someone you love. And subscribe, as always. Like the video, all that good stuff. Thank you and have a wonderful day.